Hello future engineers, welcome to my YouTube channel. If you're still new to my channel and you like what I'm doing, please don't forget to share my videos to your friends and to your friends' friends. To your younger brothers and sisters who would want to take up engineering in the future, and to your relatives. That's one way you can keep me going inspired and refreshed. Now, if you find my videos interesting and important to your studies, also, please don't forget to subscribe. Engineers in Progress 4.1. I hope that in this video, you will improve your algebraic skills, especially in simplifying fractions. Still on fractions, and this is the direction. Perform the operations and express the result as a simple fraction in lowest terms. So I have presented here 7. And 2 for your part. And I want you to actively participate in all these videos. You might find this simple, but it will enhance your mathematical skills needed in your engineering preparations, whatever field, engineering field you are taking up, you are currently taking up. So for the guide, we have numerator 1 over denominator 1. Then we express that or times numerator 2 over denominator 2. And let's find common factors and cancel them so that the result would be this final result. Final numerator or new numerator over new denominator. So this fraction, the numerator is difference of two squares, 5x quantity square minus 3y quantity square. The factors are 5x plus 3y and 5x minus 3y. Denominator, 3 squared times 5, x square y cube. So 45 is 3 squared times 5. Then 15 is 3 times 5, x cubed, y to the 4th, over 5x minus 3y. So for the constant, we cancel 5x minus 3y and 5x minus 3y. This 3 here and 1, 3 in the denominator. There is still 3 in the denominator, 5 and 5. So for the constant, there's no more constant in the numerator, but we have 5x plus 3y, then 4x, x cubed in the denominator, x squared in the denominator, so x in the numerator, 4y, y to the 4th, y cubed, so y. Therefore, the simplest terms is 5x plus 3y times xy, 5x plus 3y times xy divided by 3. There is still 3 in the denominator. So 5x plus 3y times xy over 3. For the second part, we factor out x. So this is x times x plus 3 over x plus 3, x minus 3, difference of two squares. Then factor out 3x. So we have 3x times x minus 3. Divided by x to the 4th, then times x to the 5. So we cancel x plus 3, x minus 3. So no more. Therefore, in the numerator, we have for the constant, it's 3, coefficient 3. X squared divided by x to the 4th, so x squared in the denominator, 3. Times x plus 5 over x squared. So that's the simplest terms. 3 times x plus 5 over x squared. Then for this part, 34 is 2 times 17. X cubed y divided by 7 y squared z to the 7. 35 is 5 times 7. Z to the 6 times x over 3 times 17 xy to the 8. Then times 3y to the 9z over 2 squared times 5 x squared z squared. So let's cancel 1, 2. There is still 2 in the denominator. 17, 17, 5, 5, then 7, 7, 3, and 3. So let's simplify. There's no coefficient in the numerator. For x, x to the 4th. Then we have x cubed. So therefore, there is x in the numerator. For y, we have y to the 10 over y to the 10. So there's no y, just x in the numerator. And in the denominator, we have 2. Then for z, z to the 7, z to the 6 plus 1, z to the 7. In the denominator, z to the 9. So therefore, the final answer is x divided by 2z squared. So that's the simplified terms or fraction. 3 times 5, y to the 7, z squared over 2 squared times 7. Z to the 8x, 35 is 5 times 7, x to the 9, y over 2 times 3 squared, y cubed z. Then times 3 times 7, z to the 7x over 5 squared, x to the 6, y to the 6. So for, let's cancel 3 and 3 here, 3 squared, 3 squared. Then 5, 5. 5 square and 5 square. Then 7, only 1, 7. Then we can no longer cancel constants. So in the numerator, the constant that remains is 7. For x, we have x to the 10 divided by x to the 6 and x. So x to the 7, so x cubed. 7x cubed. For y to the 7, y to the 8. Then we have y to the 9. So there is y in the denominator. For z, we have z squared, z to the 9. Then z to the 9 also. So final answer is 7x to the 3rd, 7x cubed over 2 squared times 2 over 8. Then y. Y 7x cubed over 8y. So that's it. Next, this is 3 times quantity x minus y over 2 times quantity x plus 2y times x plus 2y over x minus y. So we'll just copy, cancel x minus y and x plus 2y. So what remains is 3 halves. Then for this part, let's cancel right away. 3 and 3. Then 4, this is 2. So there is 2 in the denominator. We can cancel x plus 2y square, x plus 2y, x plus 2y. So then 1, 2x minus y. So In the numerator, we have quantity 2x minus y. Then for x, we have x squared also, so no x in the numerator. For y, we have y squared. And we also have y squared. So therefore, there's no y. The simplified form, therefore, is 2x minus y all over 2. Quantity 2x minus y over 2. So that's it. Because 4 over 8, so this is still 2. Next, 24 is 2 cubed times 3. Then q squared, quantity 2p plus 3q closed square over 5b cubed. Times 10 is 2 times 5b to the 5 over 3 square q square quantity 2p plus 3q times 2p minus 3q. This is difference of two squares. 2p quantity square minus 3q quantity square. So these are the factors. Then times 2p minus 3q, 2 times 3q to the 4th over p to the 4th. So let's cancel 3 times 3, 3 square, 3 square here, then 5, then no more. So for the constants, we have 2 cubed times 2. 16 times 2, 32. Then we have 2p plus q, just 1. 2p minus 3q. So again, the constant is 32 in the numerator. And we have 2p plus 3q, 4p, p to the 5. Then we have p to the 7. So p squared in the denominator. For q, q squared. Q to the 4th, so q to the 6th. Then q cubed only. So therefore, we have 32 q cubed over p square. So 32, 2p plus 3q, q cube over p square. So that's it. Then for your part, I want you to simplify this and show that the answer is 27y cube over 40x. And for this part, show that the answer is C, quantity 3c plus 5d over 8d. So that's it, and I hope that you enjoyed watching this video, and this is for your engineering preparations.